Hello friends, welcome back. Today I will tell you about a very powerful tool of Microsoft, that is Power Query. In this video we will learn Power Query for Excel. You can transform and clean your data using the Power Query. You can also connect the Power Query from various data sources like SQL Server, from website, from multiple Excel file, MS Access, and so many data sources. First of all, I would like to tell you how can you install the Power Query for Excel at your system. Power Query can be used from Excel 2010, 13, and Excel 2016. You need to install the Power Query for Excel 2010 and Excel 2013. It is by default available in Excel 2016 under Data tab. Now here I'll tell you how can you install the Power Query at your system. So this is the link from where you can download the Power Query for Excel. I will provide this link in video's description also. So just click on download button. Now here you can see there are two options available. One is for 32-bit and second is for 64-bit. So you need to check your Excel bit version. If you are using 32-bit, then you can install this one. So I'm using Excel 2013 of 32-bit. So I'll install this Power Query and click on next. Then it will start downloading. You can see here, so it's getting downloaded. So it is completed. Once you have downloaded the Power Query, you need to install it. Make sure you have closed all the Excel and Office related files. So just open this and click on run. It has the simple installation process. Just click on next, accept, and next, next, install. So installation process will start. Just click on finish. So Power Query has been installed properly. Now if I will open Excel file, now you can see here there is a new tab available which is Power Query. You can see this tab available here. Now we can use this. I'll tell you how can you use this. This is very very useful, and you can connect the data from multiple sources. Like you can get the data from web. You just need to put the URL. You can connect from the Excel file, CSV file, XML file, or even you can connect from a folder. All the files available inside that folder will be consolidated automatically. You can use the various databases like SQL Server database, MS Access, and SQL Analysis Services database, Oracle, IBM DB2, MySQL, and there are many databases available here. And you also can connect it with the Azure online services and few other sources like SharePoint list, ODBC connection, Microsoft Exchange, etc. You can connect it directly inside the worksheet using the table or range. Now I'll show you connected with one of the Excel file. So I'll go to the from file and Excel. So we will connect from a different Excel file. So I have this Excel file here. Just copy this path and just paste here and select the sample data. So this sample data workbook has three worksheet: call data, product master, sale data. Let's say I want to take only call data for the time being. So you can click on edit directly, load. So let's say I'm just clicking on edit. It will take me on the Power Query editor window, which will be opened separately from the Excel. You can see the Excel book one window is this, and this is the call data Power Query editor. So just open this. Now here you can see the different columns are available. So basically you can transform your data according to your requirement. You can make it clean. You can add few columns. You can delete few columns. You can aggregate the data. There are so many options. So we will learn each and every option in upcoming videos. I'll create the entire series of Power Query tutorial. Friends, this is very, very useful and very demanding in the market nowadays. I will highly recommend you to learn the Power Query. So in the upcoming videos, we will learn how we can use this. Now I'll show you, once you will make all the changes here, you just need to click on close and load. You can see here it is available here and it will give you the data in a Excel worksheet. Once your data is available in a Excel worksheet, you can use your data. Alright, so we will learn in the upcoming videos the various functionality available inside the Power Query Editor. So please watch the next video. I'll create the entire series of this. Thank you so much for watching.